Hey everyone, I'll be covering all of the Nintendo Switch's games announced for the 4th week of October, so let's get started. Valine has confirmed that Shores Unknown will be releasing on Switch after the game comes out of early access on PC. This deeply customizable RPG has you setting off on a journey through a land full of war. Build a perfect mercenary team of your choice with an adaptive character system that learns new classes and your skills based on how you equip each and every one of your characters. Take your time, assess the situation, and command your group accordingly to come out victorious. Hit the road while building a career out of it in Truck Driver. Each hole has a purpose, be it earning some cash, helping out a friend, or any of the tons of engaging scenarios you'll be thrusted upon. Develop relationships with the people and the companies you help to further your career. Customize your truck and tune it into your liking while navigating on a sprawling landscape full of requests. Asmodee Digital announced that Arkham Horror: Mother's Embrace is releasing on Switch in 2021. This is a squad-based narrative adventure game set in 1926, where a professor is found dead in her mansion. You then pick from 12 characters, each with their own unique set of skills, and assemble a team of investigators to uncover the secrets behind this mysterious death. Take control of your own space agency at the dawn of the space age. Build up facilities for the end goal should be touching down on Mars, but setting your own goals is also optional in Mars Horizon, a mission-based strategic sim with tons of turn-based tense combat, where each one of your decisions is critical for not just the survival of the crew, but the mission at hand. The first Fire Emblem game never came out in the West, and Nintendo set out to rectify that with Fire Emblem Shadow Dragon and the Blade of Light. This NES classic will include English language localization for the first time ever, as well as rewind feature, a fast forward feature, and even save states to allow any and all tactical RPG fans to enjoy this classic for a brand new generation. The slice of life story where you build houses out of cards to bring formative memories to life where cards fall is a creator's paradise in a dreamlike spatial scenario where puzzles and navigation meet. Tackle over 50 in total with a creative coming-of-age story told through unique dialogue options in a unique art style inspired by contemporary artistic movements. KG Project has started a crowdfunding campaign for Kowloon's Rhyme Zone: A Day of the Fire, targeting a Switch release in fall of next year. This is a direct sequel to the 1997 PlayStation game Kowloon's Gate that will use real-time rendering in a back-alley type open-world experience where you'll easily lose sight of the objective and take on the real focus to explore the sprawling environments. Driven by revenge, love, and loss, Reyna emerges from the ruins of a crumbling nation to rescue Jericho and Reyna and Jericho, an action platformer where fighting for your future while correcting your mistakes of your past are at the forefront of the conducive gameplay. Gather power-ups that synergize with one another to enhance your fighting abilities and create a perfect chain that takes down foes. Experience multiple endings depending on the choices that you make and which enemies you decide to befriend. Overcome all challenges and collect and tame wild beasts in Monster Sanctuary. Each of your new captures has a deep skill tree and molds them into the battler you want them to become, as a mysterious force threatens peace around the globe and humans are put in peril, including tactical 3v3 turn-based combat in a deep Metroidvania explorational world with plenty to do and tons of challenges at your fingertips. The Kickstarter project for Grand Exile is in the works and a Switch alongside a PC release have been confirmed. Using 80s and 90s inspired pixel art visuals, each character uses varying sets of weapons and fighting styles to stand out from the rest. A combo-heavy combat system with precise button presses and timing will force you to read your enemies accordingly and react when needed. Originally released on mobile, Hatsune Miku Logic Paint is a Picross game featuring the world's most popular Vocaloid. Clear stages to unlock gorgeous illustrations from a variety of collaborators, with over 150 in total spread through 225 stages. Touchscreen support has been included, as well as a new hint function system and a suspend feature for all stages. Originally released on the 3DS, Corpse Party: Blood Covered Repeated is getting remastered for the Nintendo Switch later this year. The survival adventure game is one of Meg's biggest franchises that on Switch will add new voice acting, a brand new extra chapter, extra scenarios that were not originally voiced in the 3DS entry, new visuals, a new audio, and much more. A Western release has still not been confirmed. The beautiful 2D pixel art Metroidvania slash platformer Death Stick lets you follow in the footsteps of Mako, tasked with stopping a dark ritual of a god's awakening. Embark on a fascinating adventure to uncover what's going on in the world and discover her true destiny. Shift locations through a unique 180-degree warp ability and change the perspective and the way you traverse the world, all while engaging with toughest now enemies. Brunswick Pro Billiards is an immersive billiards game featuring licensed pool tables, cues, and sets. Compete against friends and other players online for Brunswick Bucks and use those winnings to upgrade your equipment and the tables or hone your skills versus AI opponents and several challenging options. Tackle a solo career or focus entirely on online and dominate the leaderboards. Curate announced that the Fantasy Tavern Sexset series is coming to the Nintendo Switch, and the first three volumes are already in the works. Fantasy Tavern Sexset Volume 1, New World Days, Volume 2, Adventurer Days, and Volume 3, Postlude Days, are all romantic edgy visual novels about a young cook working behind the scenes at an Akihabara-made cafe being reincarnated into an entirely new world. A release for next year is expected. Mon Cage is a vignette adventure puzzler where you explore a strange cube. Each of the faces of the cube is a window into a unique world, and each shares a relationship with the other sides. Weave your way through each side and connect all the dots in a multi-dimensional path. Rotate and find the proper perspective while leveraging optical illusions to help you discover the hidden link. After a cataclysmic blaze devastates the world and the laws of nature themselves, twisted meta-beings now wander the barren streets. In order to survive this world, the people begin to cling to delusions called Baroques and become warped by their very own ideas. Atone for your sins, save yourself and humanity in Baroque Original Version, a game that originally released back in 1998 and is now being remastered for the Switch, including new assets, new sounds, several gameplay and quality of life changes, the option to save at any time, and rework controls from the original Sega Saturn release. Explore the Scandinavian hamlet and the surrounding regions in Nine Witches Family Disruption, as you interact with over 50 characters, each more colorful than the last, while uncovering new clues to help you stop the Third Reich's dark designs, invoking war-era tactics and dark comedy around every corner. Lord of the Click gives you control of an army in one click. Tap onto a castle to amass coins and use them to buy armies to put on the battlefield. Each unit is displayed in real time, ready to march on to defend your tower. Control the battlefield and reach to the other side of the field. Choose your hero and challenge other players in the family-friendly cartoony strategic battler, Brawl Chast. With 5 levels of difficulty, a single-player campaign, online multiplayer options, and even brain training exercises, lead your army to victory either alone or with friends. Death Ray Manta is a top-down arena shooter where you blow up enemies using colorful laser beams. Collect gems for bonuses, dish out damage to the competition, and always aim for a personal high score across 32 stages, ever increasingly more colorful than the last, with more challenges ready to thwart your progress. Your journey has 6 chapters in Toronos, a survival action game where you're trapped in an ancient labyrinth and constantly being chased by a mythical minotaur of legend. Reach the center of the dungeon to escape or fall to his constant, never-ceasing assault. Use skills, traps, deception, and even head-on combat to keep him at bay across a dark Greek-themed adventure with only 2 combatants. Shoot 'em ups meet Battle Royale in Star 99. This arcade-style shmup lets you perform chain kills on your enemies and send special bosses and even debuffs to wreak havoc on your opponent. Compete with 98 other players until one survives. Pick from 6 playable characters with private online lobbies and the option to turn on cross-platforming with PC, Steam, and Xbox. Merge neighboring cards in the correct order to beat the dealer in blackjack hand. Enjoy over 50 handcrafted levels designed for experienced blackjack players and newcomers alike. Blast your way through colorful filled stages in a search for the last boss in Crimson Clover World Explosion. Tackle the endless waves in this arcade shmup in a bevy of different modes, either tailored to your experience or how long you wish to survive. Then pick a ship and bullet massacre as many enemies as possible. And that's what the Game & Answers will be covering this week. We're deep into the year and the game announcers have not only fully slowed down, but the quality has as well. With E3, Tokyo Game Show, and several other events behind us through the summer, the only milestone announcements we can point and look forward to are the inevitable Nintendo Direct Mini Showcase, which we should be getting one sooner rather than later, and of course, the Game Awards in early December. But after that, we probably won't be seeing any major reveals until Nintendo decides to host an actual Direct early next year, hopefully rectifying the somewhat lackluster 2020. So with all that said, as per always, thank you guys so much for watching. I truly appreciate the support, and be sure to leave a like and subscribe and hit the bell to receive notifications when the videos go up. See ya!